Hello, friends. My name is Nick Klemetson, Director of Music and Organist here at St. Paul's Lutheran Church and School, and welcome back to Music on Mondays. This week, I wanted to record some hymns on St. Paul's organ for you. However, when I went to do my recording session this week, I discovered that the balcony was quite a bit of a construction zone. So rather than try to work around the clutter and the dust, I just came home and I thought maybe it would be interesting to show you the way I'm able to practice organ here at home. This whole project started about a year ago. St. Paul's Sanctuary is a very busy place, and that is a great thing. It's great to have a vibrant, you know, living church building. However, it was proving difficult for me to find kind of the peace and quiet and solitude that I wanted to practice my organ music there. So I had one of two choices. I could either practice at very odd hours, you know, like from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. or something like that, or I could figure out a way to practice at home. So that's what I went with. This is a virtual organ, and it has two components. The first are the physical components, which is everything you see here, and the second are the digital components, which is an application and other parts of a computer that make the physical components actually function. So starting here, these are two keyboards. They're identical. They're Behringer UMX610 MIDI controllers. These aren't like your standard digital keyboard that I use, for example, at outdoor worship. Without a computer, these are just hunks of plastic. They don't create music on their own. Rather, they need a virtual instrument to create sound. Several of these buttons and dials aren't things that I actually use for the virtual organ, but I do use these small rectangular buttons here. They function as pistons on the organ, just like I can use on a real organ. The second keyboard in the back is mounted a few inches higher on a very sophisticated piece of styrofoam. Styrofoam block, real high tech. The second physical component is down below, and it was the most expensive, most difficult to find, but the most critical part of creating a virtual organ. As you likely know, the primary difference between playing organ and piano is using the pedal board and playing additional notes with your feet. This pedal board is completely digital, and it functions in the same way that the keyboards do through what is called MIDI, or musical instrument digital interface. A MIDI file isn't actually music at all, or it's not actually an audio file. It's a digital signal or a digital storage of information. With this information can be reinterpreted as music. The way MIDI actually works is a bit beyond the scope of this talk, so I digress. Anyway, attached to the pedal board is a digital swell pedal that functions the same way that the swell pedal on a standard organ would. It allows me to open and close with my foot the virtual swell shutters to create dynamics with the swell division of the virtual organ. Next is this bench that you see here. This bench was built in an afternoon by myself and Gerald Becker, who's a St. Paul's church member. I went over to his woodshed with an idea for a bench, and I actually left that afternoon with a bench. It was amazing. It was a wonderful experience. I was in awe of his expertise and his craftsmanship and his willingness to use an afternoon to help me out with this project. It is extremely heavy. And it's built like a tank, and it's probably the only component of this virtual organ system that will outlive me and my career. This bench is built to last. And the final physical component is the monitor that you see here. This is a ViewSonic TD2021. It's a pretty standard computer monitor. The only difference is that it is a touchscreen. And this way I can use my finger to set organ registrations as well as turn pages in my digital organ music, rather than having to use a mouse for that, which would be rather tricky to do when you're trying to play at the same time. So that pretty much covers it for the physical components of the organ. Let me switch some things around in the setup and I'll be able to talk better about the digital components of the virtual organ. Okay, I'm back and I'm now seated at the organ. And the digital part of the virtual organ comes in two parts. The first is the actual software that drives the virtual instrument, and that is an application called Hauptwerk, which is a German word that literally translates to main work. But in an organ, it's referring to a specific division of the organ, specifically the great division. And we talked about that in my organ video from a while ago. Hauptwerk is a computer program owned by Milan Digital Audio that enables playback of a virtual organ sample set. And the second part is what I just mentioned. That is a sample set of a real-world organ. The process of creating a virtual organ sample set is an extraordinarily complex task, but it boils down to recording each pipe of each rank on the organ to allow for reproduction later. The sample set I use is the one that comes free with the Hauptwerk software. That is the Brindley and Foster organ built in 1907. It contains 30 stops spread across three divisions, and it's the perfect fit for the physical components that I have. Tonally, it's absolutely nothing like St. Paul's organ. Specifically, this is an English design, and that organ is German, but it has the same families of stops that our organ does that I discussed several months ago in that Music Monday video. So as we discussed in that Music Monday video from several months ago, organ stops are kind of grouped into families. The main kind of organ sound is a principal, and this is what the 8-foot principal sounds like on this organ. We can add the 4-foot principal on top of that. Then the 2-foot on top of that. And finally the mixture on top of that to create what we call in organ playing the planum. There's also a planum on the swell, just like there is on St. Paul's organ. And this is what that planum sounds like. It's quite a bit different. It's almost as though it were an echo of the original. This is the two planums combined. Or this is one right after the other, and then I can actually combine them together. Here's the first one. And we can combine them together. It's a nice full sound, and that's without the pedal. I forgot to put my shoes on before I started. Anyways, this organ also has strings. The string stops on the on the swell sound a little bit like this. And that's only at the 8-foot level. There's actually kind of a 4-foot component that goes along with that. And this is what the 8 and the 4 sound like together. The organ also has flutes. Both divisions have flutes. This is an 8-foot flute on the grate. Compared with an 8-foot flute on the swell. And finally, the organ has reeds, and it has quite a few of them. It has a primary trumpet on the grate. It also has a 4-foot version of that as well, which is really just the same rank transposed up an octave, and you can, so it's essentially playing double the notes just with the same rank. There's also a smaller trumpet that's over on the swell. It's a little bit gentler. Instead of having a 4-foot companion, it actually goes the other way and has a 16-foot companion, and this is what those sound like together. And let's see, there's an oboe on the swell. And finally, there's a clarinet. And that pretty much covers it for the sounds that this organ can provide. Much like any organ, you can combine all of these sounds together. And very similar to what I would have on St. Paul's organ, is I just set up various levels for playing hymns, for example, that ascend from softest to strongest. And those kind of ascend like this. So yeah. that's pretty much my digital organ. With a budget of about $2,000, I was able to put this practice instrument together that allows me to practice at home and just get a lot more work done. Since this is an early 20th century English organ, I'll close this Music Monday by performing a piece by an early 20th century English composer by the name of Alec Rowley. This is his Benedictus.